Hey guys, welcome to Pearls of Eden. A lot of people wonder where my stance is on racism and classism and sexism. Are these factors in the African American society? And not only are these factors in our society, our world, but it's a factor for many people in the world systems in one way or the other. And I say world systems a lot because YouTube is very good about tracking certain words. So I have to be very careful in what I say. But yes, these things exist. Why? Because we are sinful, fallen nation, sinful nature. And until God comes back for his church, there will always be sin on the earth until we get a new heaven and a new earth. And so are these factors in the African American community? Do they exist? Absolutely. This is why you have to be hidden in Christ. This is why it's so important that you have a relationship with Christ. Because as I always say, greater is he that is within you than that which is in the world. But you've got to know your God in whom you believe. And when you have that kind of faith and trust in God, you know that you're an overcomer, you're a victor, and that no one can get the better of you at the end of the day, that God can open doors that no man can shut. So while yes, racism is a factor, sexism, classism, are all of these isms that are in our society, yes, they can very well be a factor, but when you are a child of God, no one can stop the promises and the blessings that are marked on your life. And that's what I have to remind people of, because they'll say, you know, black people, we have gone through so much as people. Why do we seem to be attacked so much? And from the beginning of the world, there's always been a group that's been attacked. There's always been a people that has been persecuted. There's nothing new under the sun. And I believe the only way that you can ever arise and shine to your true identity is through the word of God. That's the only way you're going to ever know in whom you are, whose you belong. Because there's so much wickedness in the earth. And is there an agenda to take certain groups off of this planet? Absolutely. You don't have to do too much research to understand that. You know? This is why it's so important to not only know your history, but it's so important to be planted in the Word of God, to be filled with the Spirit of God, because he's going to lead you to all truth. He's going to be able to help you to distinguish between the truth and the lie, because there's so much deception out there. There's so many things that appear to be the right answer, that look like they have all of the right connections to connect all of the dots. And it's deception, child of God. So you have to be very careful. A lot of people say, you know, everything is, you know, so misconstrued and confusing because everything's been turned upside down. We have to be reprogrammed in a sense. You're right. You have to be reprogrammed with a renewed mindset in Christ, because the world systems, the way they have programmed everything, left is right, up is down, everything's a lie. It's been twisted and manipulated for their proper gain. When you talk about stolen identity, man, if you don't read the word of God, you will forever walk around not knowing who you are with an X. Okay? But once you meet your Savior, Jesus Christ, once you read the word and you begin to apply the commandments and the principles into your life, and you begin to see things shifting for the better, and you begin to know in whom you believe, your eyes become open to so much truth. The veil is removed. Only God can remove the veil. And when he removes the veil to show you some things, man, it's like, how did I not see that before? It's like he'll show you things that were in plain sight. Everything is right there for you to see, but you have to have eyes to see. You have to have ears to hear. So I'm saying all of this. Yes, all of those things are factors. We, the African American the black people of the world, we're very special people. Why do you think they come after us so hard? But the problem is we've been programmed in such a way. There's so much brainwashing. There's so much, y'all, there's not enough time and space to discuss what all has happened to the African-American people and specifically in our nation and our country. But there comes a point where you have to rise above the oppressed mentality, the victim mentality that they want you to have. And when I say they, I don't mean white people. I mean the world system, the powers that be, the principalities and the people in high places are banking and hoping that you have a defeated mindset. And you have to teach your children about who they are. You have to read the word to them. You have to lift them up and encourage them and to know that all things are possible for them in Christ Jesus. That they don't have to have this mindset that everybody's against them. Because if God be for you, who can be against you? So I don't raise my boys from the perspective of everybody's against you. And you're this or that, and these are the struggles that you will have because of your race. I don't teach my children that kind of nonsense. I teach them their identity in Christ and who they are. That they are royal priesthood. They are chosen nation. So we have to rebuild our communities by first teaching our children and building the family, building first the faith, family, keeping God first, because they've removed God out of so many places and institutions and schools and everywhere. You've got to keep God first. We have so many black people that want to run to every other religion, not knowing the very book that they're running away from is about them. You know, all you have to do is open up your Bible. And you'll see throughout the pages of the scriptures that you are there. But no, we want to run away. We want to call Christianity the white man's religion because we're ignorant, not knowing that before we were even brought here on slave ships, that we had a history in the scriptures. That our history is so rich and steeped with Yahshua HaMashiach, Yahweh, when we would sing the songs like Hallelujah. But because people don't have understanding and they don't have knowledge and they rather watch Netflix than read, they don't know who they are. So they buy this lie that somehow that Christianity is the white man's religion, and they never pick up a Bible and learn of God for themselves. And the truth is, guys, it's not about race. That is a trick from the enemy. The enemy wants white people to get, you know, triggered into thinking they're superior. The enemy hopes the black people think that they're oppressed. It's all a trick. His devices are so crafty. Racism is evil, it's sinful, it's wicked. And you have to come up out of that. When we worship God in spirit and truth. This, what you're fighting over, where people are trying to be superior over, or hold people thinking you're better because of your skin color, or thinking you're less than because of your skin. This is dirt. This is flesh. This is just a bodysuit, people. When you leave, when it is your time to go, it is your spirit that's going to arise. This is just dirt, people, flesh. And if you think somehow because of the color of your skin makes you better or makes you chosen, then you are sadly mistaken. And so I just wanted to talk to you a little bit about my perspective on that. I'm really big about kingdom first. Kingdom first. I don't put my nationality or culture above that. I respect all of those things. And I think that's beautiful. I love the heritage that the Lord has blessed me to be a part of and to know. But first and foremost, I'm a child of God, and I never let anything take the place of that. Nothing comes before that. So anyways, I hope this brings some clarity and just gives you my perspective. I do believe, yes, there are definitely demonic factors in the world. There are people that are so hateful. They hate people because of the color of their skin. There are people that think they're going to go to an all-white heaven or all-black heaven. And I'm like, what book are you reading? Obviously, you haven't picked up the Word of God ever. Because there will be all nations and tribes speaking different tongues. And if you can't get over yourself in this world, how are you going to make it in the next? I understand, but that's the sinful nature of man. That's sin, to hate someone. How can you hate your brother but love God whom you've never seen? That's what the scriptures say. But you got people who hate other people based on were raised in, based on economic status, based on colorism and racism and ethnicity. It's very sad. It's just a trap. It is just a trap from the enemy to get you distracted. It's not worth it. It's not going to get you into the kingdom. So, anyways, I could go on and on. Those are my thoughts, and I hope that you all have a blessed and beautiful day. Thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you for sharing the videos. And I really appreciate your support and your encouragement. So I'll see y'all next time. Bye.